actually go in and test 1,000 Trails membership campground. These places are really cool. I really like them because, you know what, they treat you really good. I've been to several of them, and we're going to stay in a yurt. I've never stayed in a yurt before. I don't even really sure what a yurt is and what it's all about. I mean, I've seen pictures online and stuff like that, but I really don't know. I've stayed in cabins. I've built cabins, but I've never actually stayed in one. So let's go check it out. This is the one up on the northern I-5 corridor in Washington State. It's called Mount Vernon. Really, really pretty place. It's exit 236. You go east off the freeway to the very first road, and you turn north. You drive past the casino like you're going right through its parking lot, it seems like. And then you're right there. So you think you're going into another part of the parking lot, but you're actually in the preserve. So let's go check it out. Let's take a look at this yurt and see what it is and see how the people treat me. I bet they do good. They always do everywhere I go. Every resort I've been in, they've just been wonderful. So let's see how they are at this one.
Let's see. 1,000 Trails. Encore public RV sites now available. Let's see, a stop sign. Check in to the right. So let's see. Let's go to the right here. Never been here, so I really don't know what to expect. It looks like we've got a ranger station coming up. I don't see anybody here. Oh, look at that. There's some kind of call box. Well, let's go out and call them.
To contact the ranger, please use the phone on the wall above and left. Lift the cover, pick up the phone, and depress the button on the phone handle and speak into the phone. Release the button and the ranger will answer. After using the phone, please cover and hang up. All right, well, let's give it a shot.
Hello, ranger. I'm here to stay in one of your yurts.
Be right there.
All right, thanks. Well, that was pretty quick. He answered right away and friendly. Let's see how long it takes him to get here.
Let's see. Notice, this preserve will continue to be open during the fall, winter, and spring for your camping. For your camping pleasure. See you then. Caution, automatic gates. Looks like they got a keypad because they got it blocked off here so that only the people that are supposed to be in here can be in here. That's nice and secure. So let's see. Very nice. Nice looking guard shack they got here. I don't know if you call it a shack. It's more like a nice little cabin almost. It's nice and roomy. That in the summer, it's just full of nice people. Oh, there they come. Here comes a minivan with a flag attached to it. That's got to be the person. All right. Well, that's pretty quick. More than a couple minutes.
Hi.
Hi, how you doing? I'm Zach. That's me.
How are you today?
I'm doing great.
That's good. Did you need a linen cap or anything like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I need to have whatever it takes to sleep.
Okay.
I brought was some
up.
Clothes. All right.
I'll bring one up.
Never been here before, so you got to tell me where they're at.
Alrighty. Here's the key.
Okay.
Just in case you want to leave and go do anything. Here is the gate code. You have to hit the pound sign.
Okay.
Then this number.
Okay.
And then it changes tomorrow. Are you going to be here tomorrow?
Nope, just one night.
Just one night? Oh, okay.
One night.
Well, this is the one you need. Right there.
Excellent.
And you don't need all this.
Nope.
None of that stuff.
All right.
Okay. But I will give you a map.
And I'm at A59.
Yeah. We had you in the cabin, but they said you wanted the yurt.
Yeah, I've never stayed in a yurt before, so I want to see what it's like.
All right, we can do that.
So,
here,
right.
I'll give you this.
Which one do you think is better, the cabin or the yurt?
I like them both.
good.
So it doesn't, you know, I'm not biased. I like them both. I've stayed in both of them.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you're right here. You'll go through the gate. There's a little speed bump. You go over the speed bump. They'll take the left and follow it all up and around here. And you're right there in the first one.
Excellent. Thanks.
Okay? And I'll get that linen pack up to you. Okay?
Excellent. Thanks a lot.
You're very welcome.
All right, she said, go up to the corner up here and take a left. Traced it all out with highlighter on the map. That's pretty good. I should probably do the speed limit. It's only the right thing to do. So I'm going to turn left here. Your roads are in pretty good shape.
Sometimes the winter can really take its toll on a road. Too bad. So anyway, let's follow this around here. Looks like we got a little ways to go. Not too many folks here yet. Wow, look at these sights. These are nice. These are really nice sights. All right, here we go. Somebody coming the other direction here. So make sure we stay out of the way and. Drive around them here. They got a couch in the back of that. House cleaning. Must be taking the couch out for a walk. All right. Looks like some, a shower house here. Very nice. Okay. So, can't be too much farther. We're almost there. It's a pretty big place. We're just in one little part of it. See something round up there. I see a couple of round things. Must be a yurt. Alright. Let's see here. I am in which yurt? Let's see here. Alright. It's a yurt. Well, let's go check it out. All right, here we are at A59. Let's go up on the porch here. Let's see, what do we have? We have a barbecue. Awesome. Comes with a barbecue, a nice big porch. Door with a window. It's a wooden door. That's interesting. A round tent with a wooden door. How sweet is that? Holy smokes, look at the inside of this joint. This is cool. Check this out. From the inside, you see the lattice work on the walls. Looks like a window. This has got to be a window. Let's take a look. Well, no, it just kind of looks like one. That's interesting. Oh, maybe it is. Looks like you can open it from the outside. Let's take a look. Hey, look at that. You can. You want light? You open this guy up. There it is. It's a window. How cool is that? How cool is that? All right. You got a full kitchen in this thing. Look at that. You got a kitchen. You got that up there. You've got a sunroof in the middle. This is neat. A couple of bunk beds. Look at this really rustic, nice floor. Looks like a futon you can fold down. Let's see, that's, you can sleep two down there, one up there, and two more over here. That's five people you could sleep. Look at this, there's a little fireplace here. Looks like it's gas, I'm guessing. I see a little pilot light in there. And then, in here, there's a shower. Very cool. A toilet. A pedestal sink. Everything, all the comforts of home. What a gorgeous little place. Complete with a nice television. And, looks like, oh, that's your cable.
or your satellite dish receiver, so all comforts at home. And she's bringing me a linen package, so I'll actually have something to sleep on under. Very nice. Let's see. Lights and fans and windows and even a clock. How timely. I think I could live in something like this.
And what a great place to sit back, crack open a cold one, and knock back a brew. Recommend it. It's really nice. And I'll let you know in the morning how it sleeps. So how'd it go last night? Well, in my opinion, pretty darn good. Because I slept well. It wasn't my mattress at home, but it never is, right? You don't bring your mattress with you. But one thing I did notice is that you gotta keep in mind that when you're staying in a yurt, it's not a hotel room. Check this out. See how the sides are a tent. So it is a tent. And so you're going to be staying in a tent. Now, it's got a nice floor. It's got heat. It was warm. It was comfortable. I had beds. It was dry. It was like the best of everything you could possibly want. It's a best case scenario tent. The biggest problem I had in the whole experience, and really I should have expected it, is that because the walls are tent walls, you could hear everything that went on outside, which is okay. I mean, it's not loud here other than a slight bit of traffic noise from the nearby freeway, but, you know, it is what it is. Nothing they could do about it here as a resort. And another thing to remember is that when it comes to resorts, and it's not just Thousand Trails, this goes across the board. When you go to a resort like this, you either bring your own blankets and pillows and sheets and stuff and towels, or you can get what's called a linen package for a small fee, which it works either way. Some people like to bring their own stuff. They prefer to use their own towels and use their own things, but other folks, they want them provided while they're there. Well, you can get it either way. It's just you pay a little less if you bring your own. Kind of works out nice, and it's reasonably priced, for the convenience and everything. We're less than a mile from the casino, if that's what you're after, and we're about a mile from the freeway, so if you want to get on the freeway and go somewhere, you're not too far from Bellingham or Mount Vernon area, so it's pretty handy. All in all, I think it's a pretty nice place.